Okay, for this video, I'm going to discuss depreciation, topic on depreciation. Okay, depreciation is the decrease in the value of a physical property with the passage of time. So, decrease in the value. For example, if you will buy an equipment now, 10 or 15 years after, ang value na is kuan, mo decrease na. So, ana ang depreciation. So, let us first define or know the definitions of value. Okay. First is the market value. Market value is the amount which a willing buyer will pay to a willing seller for the property, where each has equal advantage and is under no compulsion to buy or sell. Eh? So, yun na ang market value. Book value is the worth of a property as shown on the accounting records of an enterprise. Based sa accounting records. Like, for example, if you buy a property now and na sa life of, let us say, 20 years, and then after 8 years lang, and after 8 years nga nag-operate, you want to sell it. Okay? So, pila may value sa property ni mo na, during na time, 8 years. So, based sa accounting records, makita na mo na ang value sa property. So, ang tawag na is book value. Salvage or resale value is the price that can be obtained from the sale of the property after it has been used. Okay. Salvage or resale value. Okay. So, after sayang life, after magamit ni mo, you want to sell it, salvage value ang tawag or resale value. And also we have this one, scrap value. Scrap value is the amount the property would sell for if disposed of as junk. So, kung i-consider ni mo siya nga junk, then imo siya ibaligya, scrap value ang tawag. So, depende na lang sa problem. Sa sometimes salvage value ang gamit, sometimes scrap value. So, for this topic, let us know or differentiate physical and economic life. Okay. Physical life is the length of time during which it is capable of performing the functions for which it was designed and manufactured. To differentiate, the economic life, on the other hand, is the length of time during which the property may be operated at a profit. So, kana na length of time is profitable pa ang imong property. Okay. Nga kung i-compare ni mo ang income ang expenses, mas bigger pa ang income kesa expenses. So, ana na time, economic life pa siya. Part sa economic life. Beyond na, nga ang expenses mas bigger na kaysa income, then dili na siya part sa economic life. But still, part pa siya sa physical life kay the function mangyapon. Okay. For as long as the function siya, part siya sa physical life. So, how are we going to determine the depreciation charge period or the decrease in value of a property? There are several methods that you can use. Okay. Dili same ang result ani ng mga methods. Okay. So you cannot compare the value using one method to the value using another method. dili equal ang result. So these are the common methods. The straight line method, the very popular, the very simple one. Straight line method, the sinking fund method, the declining balance method, the double declining balance method, and the SYD or the sum of years digit method, common. There are other methods na really common, like service output method, working hours method. We also have the MACRS, Modified Accelerated Cost Recovery System method. Okay. Let us know the different symbols used in a topic. L is the useful life of the property in years. Useful life. C sub O is the original cost. Okay. First cost. Sometimes ang nakasulat sa problem is first cost. So, ang first cost includes the cost of the property and other expenses like transportation, handling, freight, all expenses nga ma-incur before siya nag-operate is part of the original cost. C sub O, no? Zero man ang time. C sub L is the value at the end of the life. Scrap value siya pag i-consider din mga junk, pero pag dili, salvage value siya. Okay. Ang iyong life is L man. It could be physical life or economic life. D is the annual cost of depreciation, the depreciation charge, no? Or the decrease in the value of the property every year. Small d. C sub N is book value at the end of N years. Like sa akong gishare kanina na illustration na if you have a property having a life of 20 years and then you want to sell it after 8 years of using the property, 8 years, book value ang tawag. So, ang N niya is equal to 8. D sub N is depreciation up to the age in years. Pag capital D, it's total depreciation. So, suppose N equals 5. Depreciation up to 5 years. Meaning, i-add ni mo D1 plus D2 plus D3 plus D4 plus D5. Total man. Pag capital D. Okay. So, let us discuss the first method. The straight line method. This is the simplest method. To illustrate, okay, let's graph. Ang x-axis is ang life sa property. And then ang y is the monetary value. Okay. So, at year zero, ang value sa property ni mo is equal to the original cost, CO. This one, CO. Now, kung dili lang tayo mo consider og depreciation, meaning ang value sa property is constant siya, ay regardless the number of years, ang graph ani should have been horizontal. No decrease in the value of the property, pero mo depreciate man siya, so mo decrease ang value sa property. So after sa iyang life na L, ang value sa yung property is dili na dire, no? Somewhere here. Baba na. No? So, suppose na dire. So, at L, isa, L number of years, sa iyang life. No? Ang tawagan niya is salvage value or scrap value. So, project na to sa y-axis, si sub L na dyan. Okay. So, ang graph, showing the value of the property is straight line. So, connect na nimo. Na, eh? So, kumukuha kang Y value, let's say, when X equals 1, 1 year, when X equals 1, what's the value of Y? Mao na ang imong book value. Okay. Okay. Sa L, ang difference sa value sa CO o sa CL, this is the total depreciation after sa iyang life. We can denote this one as D sub L. Okay. O total depreciation after sa iyang life. Okay. So, sige. Suppose, dere, for year one, money ang value niya. Ana, year one. Okay. So, ang drop sa value niya is called the annual depreciation charge. Kana D. Supposed to be D1. Pero sa straight line, uniform ang decrease kay straight line. So, let's get rid of the subscript. So, instead na D1, just D lang. So, year 2 na, dali, no? Ang drop na is D2 or D lang yapon. Same raman. And so on, year 3, drop ka, year 4, year 5, okay, kana. Suppose, this is N, okay, N years. So, ang Y, ang value sa Y ani is the book value na. O Y money, book value. Project na natin ya, that's book value, okay. And ang drop sa value niya from C sub O to C sub N, that is D sub N, capital. Na, D sub N. So from this graph, okay, we can solve for D, the annual depreciation charge. Actually, the annual depreciation charge is the slope of this line. So, slope, kaniya ito gamiton, kay normal sa problem ang given kay CO, C sub L, and then life. So derita rise over run. So the annual depreciation charge is this one, CO minus CL divided by L. This is the annual depreciation charge. Constant siya every year for straight line method. Next, total depreciation up to 10 years. This one, no? Total depreciation. How do you solve for D sub N? It's very simple. Kay straight line man. So, every year, mag-drop siya og D. So, the total depreciation is actually equal to D times number of years, no? Like for this one, kung 6 lang siya, D plus D plus D. So, the total depreciation is 6D or simply N times D. So N times D. That's total depreciation, N times D. And the last one is book value after N years. This one, how do we solve for C sub N? From the graph, it's simply C sub O minus D sub N. Diba? C sub O minus D sub N is equal to C sub N. So these are the formulas sa straight line method. It's very simple. Sige. Let us solve some problems. A machine purchased for $50,000 has a depreciable life of 5 years. It will have an expected salvage value of $4,500 at the end of the depreciable life. Using the straight line method, what is the book value at the end of year two? Okay. So, the procedure here is first you solve for the annual depreciation charge, small d, and then after that, total depreciation. Because if you will go back to the formula, to solve for the book value, you need this one. Because CO is given, so you need the value of D sub N, total depreciation. Now, given money N, 2 years, so ang kulang is D. Okay? So, you need to solve for D first. So, solve for annual depreciation charge. After that, total depreciation. And then, last is book value. Okay? Okay. So, the annual depreciation charge is this. Direct substitution. CO is given 50,000. Salvage value 45. A life of 5 years. And the annual depreciation charge is 9,100. Next, total depreciation up to 2 years. Okay, so just multiply this one by 2, diba? N times D. It's 18,200. And then last book value at the end of year 2 or 2 years. Use this formula. C sub 2 equals C sub O minus D sub 2. N minus N general. No? C sub N, D sub N. So, 50,000 CO. D2 is 18,200. And the book value is this one. 31,800. Okay. It's very simple. Ah. The other problem is this. An asset for drilling was purchased and placed in service by a petroleum production company. Its original cost is $90,000 and it has an estimated market value of $15,000 at the end of an estimated useful life of 15 years. Compute the depreciation amount in the third year and the book value at the end of the fifth year of life using the straight line method. Again. So again, solve first for the annual depreciation charge. CO is given, that's 90,000. Salvage value is given, 15,000. L, useful life of 15 years. So the annual depreciation charge is 5,000. So first question, compute, first unknown is compute the depreciation amount in the third year. As we have seen sa graph a while ago, for a straight line method, the annual depreciation is constant. Whether it's first year, second year, or third year, the annual depreciation charge is the same for this method, straight line. Therefore, the depreciation amount in the third year is just equal to this one, $5,000. Eh? Next, book value at the end of the fifth year. Again, the procedure is before ka makasolve sa book value, first, you need to solve for the total depreciation after 5 years or at the end of the fifth year. So, sa book value, pero you still have to solve for what? Total depreciation. It's 5 times D. And our D is 5,000, so it's 25. After this, you can solve for the book value. This one, book value after 5 years, CO minus total depreciation after 5 years. And the book value is $65,000. That's it for straight line method. It's very simple. So you can solve as many problems as you can in order to familiarize the topic. Okay. Thank you for watching.